Yes people, what's good and welcome back to the channel guys. So today it's all about my ICP test results and what I've done to make those necessary corrections. Right guys, so if you haven't subscribed yet guys, make sure you do. So let's go straight into this video guys. So literally I have started dosing regulator O, I'll say over the last 3 weeks, just in time for the ICP test. Now what I realized that regulator O from Oshiamo does contain iodine. Now, in the past, when I've done an ICP test, I sent it off. My iodine had to be, there's some sort of correction that had to be done over the course of maybe 3 or 4 days. That's how low my iodine used to get. So dosing the part one and part two with what iodine's in there, it just wasn't staying within the required or the recommended ranges. So with dosing the regulator O now, the only correction I had to do with my iodine was literally up the amount of regulator B I have been dosing throughout the week. Now, I'm dosing about 0.3 mil every 3 days with my dosing pump. The Oshiamo recommends you can go up to 0.5. So what I've done is, I've done, rather than every other day, I've done every day at 0.2 mil. So every day is getting a consistent amount of iodine top up for the system, and hopefully that will sort out the 0.5 discrepancy that they Triton recommended that I need to correct within my system for iodine. Next thing that was recommended guys was manganese. Now, manganese is something that gets absorbed really quickly from the water column, especially for LPS corals for their growth and other metabolic functions. So that got really just sucked out my system, but thankfully I am dosing a regulator A now, Oshiamo, which has a supplementation of manganese in there. Now, the correction that Triton recommended for my manganese was about 3 mil over the course of 2 days, just roughly about that amount. So the first day was just, you know, just do half of that. The next day, I do the other half. Simple as that, guys. And that was done without any issue. Now, another trace element that was recommended by Triton was nickel. Now, I do not have the confidence, I don't possess the confidence to dose nickel into my aquarium as it's barely detectable on an ICP test, and so it states. So I'll not be messing around with nickel, I'll not be dosing any form of nickel into my system. I'll just allow regulator A, the two-part dosing system from Oshiamo, to take care of what nickel is recommended and copper into my system. Now the last trace element I had to bring into a recommended range was fluorine or fluoride. And yeah, I had to dose about 1.5 mil over the course of 6 days, guys, with the last day dosing 1.2 mil. So it was like non-existent in the system, and that was affecting my corals. Now, something interesting happened when I went away for a couple of days. So I went away for a couple of days, and I checked my pH level and my alkalinity level for the system. So my pH rose to about 8.56, which is quite high. And my alkalinity, yeah, they're closely related, dropped down to 7.3 from 7.9. So it just shows that via pH, it does affect the amount of alkalinity and calcium consumption within your system, which was a positive. It showed that the corals did grow. Now, I haven't done a water change on this in about 2 weeks because I've been away. And the coral and everything else in the system seems to be very happy. Everything is extending as normal. All the polyps are coming out, even coloring and the axial polyps as well. We have a lot of yellowing coming out there as well. And different colors are starting to pop, especially with the new lighting schedule that I, you know, implemented in January. Now, guys, I keep on bragging about this little system and the lighting schedule that I've just implemented. Now, my lighting schedule just ensures that my PER, or the usable radiation, is within acceptable ranges for my SPS. Now, it's nothing fancy for my lighting. I just have a G4 Radeon Pro, so quite old light. This is a Gen 6 now, so it's two generations behind, and Reef Bright HXOs that just take care of that supplemental lighting to raise my PAR to about 360 for about 5 hours a day. So this system, the lighting comes on bang on 9 a.m. The HXOs come on around 10:30 and they go around 3:30. So it's on about 5 hours, yeah? And after that, around 5:30, all the lights are off. All the lights are off, and I use a bin bag to cover the system so that all the corals are just in darkness, basically. Don't laugh, guys. This is what my tank looks like at night. Obviously, the lights will be off, so everything around The tank itself or inside the tank will just see pitch black. There's no ambient light from the living room light or a lamp or the television shining into the aquarium itself. So for that, it allows, I think personally, it allows the coral to go into that night mode where the feeder tentacles can come out. What I found in the past that when other people are in the front room with the telly on and the lights on, the corals seem to be just normal, like they're treating it like it's just a normal day getting that light as you know they would. Once they're in the darkness or they're in pitch black, what I've seen, polyps come out and they start to feed, and I can check my trident as well. My alkalinity dips because they're starting to feed and pulling all that good stuff to start growing. That's my theory anyway, guys. Tell me if you disagree. Leave it in the comments below, guys. Okay, guys, that's the update for the TMC Reef Habitat 60. So I'm pleased to just say that everything seems stable in this system. I am not changing anything. If I am changing anything, it's over a course of a couple of weeks rather than, you know, just shocking the system. I am checking my parameters. I am checking things like my temperature. My pH is a big one I'm checking on. My lighting schedule and the length of my lighting schedule as well, and my part and pearl ranges. Yeah. So if anyone's starting off in this hobby, guys, just ensure that you just pay attention to what you're doing and just be patient. It will click, it will come together. Right, guys, this is Naran for HC Aquatics Reefing. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, guys. I'll see you next time.